Hello friends, my name is Tushar and today we're going to talk about single source shortest path using Dijkstra's algorithm. So what is single source shortest path? So you're given a graph and you're given a source vertex and you have to find the shortest path of every other vertex from this source vertex. So for example, here I have this very simple graph and my source vertex is A and I have to find the distance, the shortest distance of every other vertex from A. So for example, C can be reached from ABC or AFC or ADFC. So the shortest distance here is via B and the distance is 6. Similarly, E can be reached via AFDE or ADE. And the shortest distance here is this and again the distance is 6. So Dijkstra's algorithm works both on directed and undirected graph as long as the weight on the edge is non-negative number. Also, Dijkstra's algorithm is a greedy algorithm and it's very, very similar to Prim's algorithm of finding minimum spanning tree, which I have already discussed in another video. Also, for Dijkstra's algorithm, we need this data structure heap plus map, which supports these four operations: add, extract mean, contains, and decrease key. And I have already talked about this data structure in Prim's algorithm. This data structure is nothing but a combination of a binary heap and a hash map. And the link to that video is also attached in this video here. So watch that video first before watching this algorithm here. So now, in the next section, let's see how Dijkstra's algorithm works. So we're going to run Dijkstra's algorithm on this undirected graph here. Here the source vertex is A and we are trying to find the shortest distance of every other vertex from A. So the way this algorithm works is I have this heap plus map data structure and then I'm going to put all the vertices in this data structure with the distance infinity from A because we don't know how far they are from A at this point of time. Then we're going to set A's distance to 0 because A is a distance 0 from itself. And then we're going to do an extract min here, so basically get A out. And then explore all its neighbors and update their distance from A. So we'll get neighbor B, D, E and update their distance, so B5, D9 and then E2 from A. And then do another extract min, so get E out and explore its neighbor, so that's F, and the distance of F from A will be whatever the distance E is from A and plus this weight here, so that's 5. So put 5 there in place of F and then keep doing this extract min until we have elements in this data structure here. This distance map is going to store the distance of shortest distance of the vertex from A, while this path map is going to help us trace back the path, the shortest path from A to every vertex. So let's do a dry run of this algorithm on this graph here. So initially our source vertex is A. So we put this value as 0. Then we do an extract min here. And then we make our current as A. So then we're going to explore neighbors of A. So the first neighbor of A is B. So let's first remove A from here and then update A's distance as 0 and A's parent as null because A is the source vertex. Then we're going to explore neighbors of A. So first neighbor of A is B. So B exists in this map here, yes. And then the distance attached with B is greater than this edge weight here. So we'll update this distance to this, basically saying that we found a path which is shorter than what you know right now. So we'll update this to 5. Then we're going to explore, also we're going to say that B's current value is coming from A. Also, then we're going to explore another neighbor, so D. And then the current distance attached with D is infinity, while this edge, while this guy says that you can reach D from A in distance 9. So we'll update this with 9 and also say that this 9 is coming from A. So D is also coming directly from A. And then explore another neighbor E. So the distance of E from A is 2 and E exists here, so we'll replace this with 2, and it will say that E is also coming from A. So at this point of time, A is totally done exploring all its neighbors, so we are going to go in here again and do another extract mill. So the least value here is E, so we'll take E out, so our current will become E. And we'll take E out and put its distance as 2. And now we'll explore neighbors of E. So the first neighbor of E is A, and A doesn't exist in this map plus heap data structure, so we just ignore A. And then the second neighbor of E is F, and F does exist here, and the value attached with F is infinity, while if we went via E, it can reach A in distance 2, whatever the minimum it takes to reach E, plus the weight of this edge. So value of F goes to 5. 2 plus 3, 5. So also we're going to say that F got introduced by E. So at this point of time, we are done exploring all the neighbors of E. So we are again going to do an extract min on this data structure. So we can pick either of them. So let's pick B. And say that the B's minimum distance from A is 5. And okay, so we'll explore neighbors of B. So first neighbor of B is A, but A doesn't exist here, so we'll just ignore A. And then another neighbor of A is B is C, and C does exist here, and the value attached with C is infinity. While if we go via route B, then it can reach A in distance 2 plus whatever is attached with B, so that's 2 plus 5, 7. And then we're going to say that C got introduced by B. And at this point of time, B doesn't have any other neighbors. So we are again going to go in and do an extract min here. So this time 5 comes out because 5 is the least value of all 3. So F is the least value of all 3. So F comes out. And we are going to update F's distance to 5. And then we're going to explore neighbors of F. So first neighbor of F is E, but E doesn't exist in this map here, so we're going to ignore E because we have already found the shortest distance of E from A. Then we're going to explore another neighbor, which is D. So currently, D does exist here, and currently we found one path to D via this route, but if we took this route, basically this route, we can reach D in a shorter distance because we can reach F in distance 5, and from F to D it will take 5 plus 2, 7. So that distance is shorter than what it is right now, so we'll replace D with 7. So before, D could be reached with distance 9, but if it took this path via F, and F can be reached in 5, and the weight of this edge is 2, so we can reach D in 7. So we're going to go here and say that now D's parent is F, because that's the guy who introduced 7 for D. Then now F has no more neighbors to be explored, so we'll again go in and do an extract min here. So let's say we got C out. So our current neighbor is C. Our current value is C. And we'll say C is 7. So now we'll explore neighbors of C. So first neighbor of C is B, and B is not here, so we'll ignore B. Another neighbor of C is D, and the value to reach D via C will be whatever it takes to reach C, which is 7, plus the weight of this edge, which is 10, which is greater than what we have here. So there is no reason to go to reach D via this route, so we'll just ignore that value. So we are done exploring all the neighbors of C. So finally, we are going to do an extract min here, and our current will become D, and we'll update D7. And then D will explore its neighbors, A, which is not there in here, F, which is also not there, and C, which is also not there. So at this point of time, we are done with the algorithm. So because this queue, this data structure is now empty. So this is the distance of every vertex from A. E is a distance 2, F is a distance 5, B is a distance 5, C is a distance 7, and D is a distance 7. If you wanted to find the path, like how do I know which path to take to reach D from A? So we just go here and go to D, and D is coming from F. So we go to F, and F is coming from E, and then we go to E, and E is coming from A. So we can clearly take this path to reach A from D. For another example is, if you want to know how to reach C, so we go here, C is coming from B, so C is coming from B, and then B is coming from A, so B is coming from A, so we take this path to reach C. So the time complexity for this algorithm is similar to Prim's algorithm, which is E log V. The reason is, we are going to apply this, the size of this this data structure in the worst case is going to be V, and then we are going to apply a decrease key extract min on this data structure E times, which is the total number of edges, and V is total number of vertices. So this time complexity will be E of log V, and the space complexity will be O of E plus V, because we might have to store as many edges or all the vertices in this three data structure here. So in the next section, let's quickly look at the code for this algorithm.
The name of the function is shortest path it takes in the graph and the source vertex from which we want to find the shortest distance of every other vertex. And then it returns a map of vertex and the shortest distance of that vertex from the source vertex. And then let's initialize our data structure. The first one is a heap plus map data structure, which supports extract min, add, decrease, and contains operation. And then the second data structure is a map, which stores the shortest distance from source vertex to every vertex. And then this one is a parent, which is useful for tracing the shortest path from source vertex to every vertex. First thing we do is we initialize all the vertices with infinite value, as we discussed before in the video. Then we are going to decrease the value of source vertex to zero, because source vertex is at distance zero from itself, and then put this value in the distance map, and also set the parent of the source vertex as null. Now we are going to iterate. Through the min heap until min heap has elements in it. So then we are going to extract the minimum value vertex from this min heap, and it returns me a heap node which has both the actual vertex and the distance of that vertex from the source vertex. Once we get this heap node, we get the current vertex from it, and also update the distance map. In distance map, we put this current vertex and the distance of this vertex from the source vertex. Then we are going to iterate through all its neighbors one by one, so we get its adjacent vertex. Then what we're going to check is if the adjacent vertex is present in the min heap or not. If the adjacent vertex is not present in a min heap, it means that we have already found the shortest distance of that adjacent vertex from the source vertex, so there is nothing to do with this for this adjacent vertex. So we just continue and go back to the top of the for loop and look for the next adjacent vertex. If the min heap does contain the adjacent vertex, so we come to this point and try to find the distance of that adjacent vertex from the source vertex while going through this current vertex. So distance.getCurrent is going to give me the distance, the minimum distance of the current vertex from the source vertex, and edge dot get weight is going to give me the distance between the current vertex and the adjacent vertex. So this new distance is the total distance from source vertex to the adjacent vertex going through this current vertex. Now what we're going to do is check if the value stored in the min hip, the distance stored in the min hip for the adjacent vertex, if it is greater than this new distance, then we are going to decrease the value in the min hip to this new distance and also update the parent of the adjacent vertex to current vertex. And then we are going to go and look at the next adjacent vertex. And once we're done exploring all the neighbors, we just go back to the top of this while loop and do the extract min and repeat the same process for another vertex. And we keep doing it till the heap is not empty. And in the end, all we do is return this distance, which has the distance of every vertex from the source vertex. So this is all I have to talk about Dijkstra's algorithm. The link to this code is in the description section of the video. Please like this video, share this video, comment on this video. Check out my Facebook page, facebook.com/tusharroy25, and check out my GitHub link, github.com/missionpieceinterview wiki. Thanks again for watching this video.